Welcome to Marta the Minimalist, a podcast for entrepreneurs like you, looking to minimalize your life, business, and mindset with your host, CEO, speaker, and best-selling author, Marta Saray Grecker.
Hey, recording live the newest episode of Marta the Minimalist. For you exclusively, obviously, in the Minimalist Method for Prosperous Female Entrepreneurs. And I'm always perpetually fixing this cowlick for you while I'm on, aren't I? Well, look, it goes crazy. It just wants to show up. It wants its 5 minutes of fame for you. All right, we're going to leave it alone. And we're going to talk to you about confidence, how you can show up when you're imperfectly you, without feeling like you're constantly thinking about offending someone, or what are they going to think of you, and my hair isn't perfect, I don't have my cute top on, and the background isn't perfect. And I want to talk to you about how showing up like that can actually be more beneficial for you than waiting until the message is perfect or the moment is perfect, and how when you get too far though, how that could create, hey, Dr. Shelley, my friend, my good friend, Dr. Shelley. And if you're here with me, tell me that you're here. But I also want to talk to you about how when you get to a point where you've achieved some success, at that point, that's a time when you have boundaries, you have standards, and perhaps that human ego that might show up as confidence could be keeping you from connecting further and reaching your next level. And I'm going to be sharing with you, hey, Natalie, and I'm going to be sharing with you a proven method on if you are looking to build your confidence, what can you do to do that? All right, let's get started. First of all, I want to ask you, if you're here with me, if you're the type that's like, I could never go live, I would mess it up, I would be a nervous wreck, I'd be sweating, my armpits would be soaking wet, I'd be smelling like BO because my nerves would just be shot. And I do want to share with you that back when I was a teenager, you would never think that I would be on here showing up weekly live, just BSing with you, because unfortunately, back when I was 14, 15, I got into a really bad group of a crowd. Obviously, that was over 20 years ago. And there was so much, unfortunately, emotional, physical, mental, and yes, even sexual abuse from peers that they actually, I became so afraid to even speak that they used to dub me the rock. So they broke me down to the point of not even speaking. And then they would pester me about that. I mean, I can talk about it now without, I mean, there's certain stories that I just will never talk about publicly, but there are stories that I recall where my best friend was just physically beating me up in front of a crowd of people. And thank goodness this was before cell phones. Or there was a time when they lit a hairspray fire by my hair while I was sleeping. Or the time she just felt like it and she took my head and she bashed it into a dresser. And I could say it nonchalantly because I've done a lot of work, right? So you can imagine that on top of that and all of the actual verbal, mental, physical, sexual abuse. That's the part that I'm still uncomfortable saying out loud, and recognizing it as such and not seeing myself as the culprit. And looking back and getting the help needed to reassess the situation. So you can imagine with that amount of abuse. Yes, Shelley, Dr. Shelley says she loves to go live because she loves communication with others. And let's just be real. The people love her too. They want more of her. Imagine if Dr. Shelley didn't go live. What kind of world would that be? But obviously, having gone through that stuff, it just brought me to a point where I would not even speak. I would not even smile. I would just sit in a chair calmly because I was afraid of whatever action I was going to take was going to lead to some sort of reaction that I wanted to avoid. Why did I keep hanging out in these groups of friends? Because you're 14, 15, your brain isn't fully developed. And clearly you're not going home telling mom and dad this stuff's going on. So they're not telling you to stop hanging out with these. They're just thinking, what the heck is wrong with my daughter? She's a total nightmare. But so if you can think of someone going from something like that to being that quiet, and then even in other groups of areas of social life, people saying like, you don't talk, you don't smile, you need a personality, and having people telling me that, like, where are you? To being able to now as an adult, after having kids and after going through some work, being able to just show up live, right? And of course, there's still the moments of, man, should I have said that? Ah, did I hurt that person's feeling? I hope I didn't offend them. You know, I'm sorry if I was insensitive. Or there's still times when we walk into church with my five kids and we're a hot mess. And I'm like, oh gosh, what they must think of me. I was, you know, a speaker who goes out and gives advice, and I just look like a hot mess every Sunday morning. But to still show up when you feel that way is really the key. I'm not saying to you that if you're at a place where you are afraid to show up, post anything, go live, say anything, if you're at a place like that, I'm not saying that once you start showing up that you won't have those little voices in the back of your head. We all have them. I'm saying that you are able to start showing up, having those voices, and to continue showing up. And I'm telling you, the proven method to do so, the proven method is to stop waiting for perfection and to just get started. And you might think, easy for you, say, Marta, you already went through it. You already are going live. You already have a team of people. You're already at, you know, owning multi-million dollar land development companies and owning multi-six figure brand agencies. What's going on there? Like, how can I do it? And I will tell you that the first proven step is to surround yourself with mentors who can walk you through it. And to surround yourself with what we like to call high vibe tribes that will walk you through it. I have a client that I've worked with that when we started working together, she wouldn't post anything. See the cowlix here? It's just crazy. And if you're listening to this, you can't see the cowlix. So, you know, you're welcome. She would not post anything because she was so afraid of what her family and her friends would think of her. They would always make side remarks about her philosophies because she's a holistic healer. And so they're not necessarily on par with the societal standards. And by the time she had completed my program, she was posting really concise messages online, sharing her mission and her vision and how she can truly heal people. And you want to know what happened? Facebook shut her down. Just kidding. That's not what happened. She started to get PMs and having conversations with people who truly wanted her help and wanted to be her ideal clients. She started to feel more confident in stepping into her power. And that when people came at her with these opinions and conversations, quite frankly, it happened less and less because she was less affected by it. She was able to say, thank you for your opinion. Thank you for sharing. Sorry if this is something that triggers you. I have nothing but love for you, but I'm going to keep sharing on my mission. Because what she began to understand was that if she was quiet, she wasn't connecting with her ideal clients. And the people who had opinions still had opinions. Yet if she started to show up with her voice and her mission and her vision, she could share her truth and connect with the people that she truly could help. Whoa, that was a mic drop. That was a literal mic drop. My mic just dropped on its own. It was like, Marta, you're not gonna mic drop. I'm gonna do it for you. She started to show up and connect with people and getting PMs from people who truly wanted her help because they were suffering. And she was a holistic nutritional healer. And so a lot of her patients would be getting, that was a literal mic drop. A lot of her clients are seeking mental health help by other therapists. But then there's also the piece where they're just not physically feeling well, or their depression and anxiety is being inflamed by dietary and life issues. And so she's able to come in and help them heal to feel physically their best, as well as they're also working on their mental health. All right. So you get from that point, and then though, what could happen is you get too confident. And this is what happened to me. I started to show up. I started to talk about whatever the heck I wanted to talk about, to mic drop, to truth bomb, to myth bust. And I started to get feedback from people that were very close to me, who were supposed to be my closest friends, yet now again as an adult. And because of my stories as a teenager, being challenged that way by friends as an adult, I became very averse to it. I blocked them off, I wrote them off, I shut them down, okay? And then I was like, you don't know what you're talking about. How dare you think of me that way, or talk about me that way, or have that sort of opinion that way, right? So it kind of went a little bit too far. Now, granted, those weren't the supportive people that I should have had around me anyways, because their feedback was not just happening honestly to my face. It was also being spread like wildfire, like little fairies of gossip. If you can, I don't know, just made that up, little fairies of gossip. But retrospectively, if that's even a word, looking back, I also could have looked at it a little bit more as, okay, well, this feedback isn't coming at me with the right energy, and it's clearly happening behind my back as well. So it could have been delivered in a different way, but what are they saying? Could I take that as an opportunity, as feedback for growth, instead of letting my ego say, how dare they, right? And quite frankly, they needed to be disconnected from at that time, because you're going to learn that as you move forward in your business, there's certain people that you just can't have certain conversations with, because they just aren't going to get it. And instead of you trying to make them get it, make them understand, make them agree with you, just be okay with the fact that they're going to react, and that their reactions are not your responsibility. But also, once you get to a certain level of business, and this is what has happened to occur, even whenever I am in conversations with multi-six-figure and million-dollar ladies, is that now they've gotten to the point where they've proven to themselves that they are at a certain place. So they become super stringent with their boundaries and their standards. Anytime somebody tries to ask a question that could be perceived as somebody trying to overstep their boundaries, they just have this adverse reaction of like, how could you be asking me this? How could you ask this of me, right? And even they are having these beautiful, loving realizations that when you approach every situation with love, even when you are at a certain point in your business, are you now making your decisions based on fear of situations like the past that were overcrossing your boundaries and hurting your feelings and triggered by you? Or are you still making decisions based on love and respect and what is best for you? So that comes in places of reassessing maybe your deadlines of when people have to get back to you to close in on a deal or a sale. Or maybe you were such an overgiver in the past. You're such an overgiver in the past. You gave so much that now you're real stingy with how much you're willing to go the extra mile for the extra person, right? And I did go through that stage of life. And now in every situation is, am I overgiving, or can I easily help this person without over stressing the resources and affecting my team or affecting my kids or affecting my husband, right? Because perhaps if we go back to point A of the lack of confidence, where you're not speaking up, you're not showing up, and also perhaps you're doing a lot of stuff for free, a lot of stuff for trade, a lot of stuff as a discount, or over giving things that people haven't paid for. You get to a point where you get past that and you get to your monetary goal. And then because you were much in the past, you then are just so stringent with your policies and your boundaries and your standards that you could be keeping yourself from that stage of life that you're at. You finally can overgive and be over generous. So I'd love for you to take an assessment of that. But if you are at the stage where you feel like you're just kind of surviving through life and you are overgiving and people are constantly taking advantage of you and you're not comfortable speaking up when, let's say, someone is overstepping a boundary, or even a waiter brings you the wrong dish, or the barista gives you the wrong drink, or your husband pisses you off for the 10th time, but you're afraid to speak up, or you feel like your kids take advantage of you, or you feel like your clients take advantage of you, and you're just strapped to the max, not making even enough for all of your efforts and energy. And what you'd love to get to is 5K a month, that 10K a month, that's just residually coming recurringly without too much effort. And you're able to say no when you just don't feel like it without giving apologies or explanations. And you have so much free time on your hands as you're bringing in income and you feel peaceful. And that anxiety that's keeping you up at night, or that anxiety that every time you have a conversation, you're second guessing yourself of what you should have said, and you're still thinking about it a day later, and you're telling everybody about the conversation, and you're just looking to be confident, confident in a way that you don't second guess your decisions, that you're able to make calls in your life without hemming and hawing for too long, that you're able to show up in lives, you're able to post things online about your business, so you can naturally attract so much income much more easily, then I have something for you. Of course I do. I have just joined as a guide for 3 months in something called the Confident Woman Collective. There are 4 to 5 other guides, each having their own area of expertise, that are going to guide you through from being the silent person who maybe doesn't even like her face or her body when she looks in the mirror, the silent person who's afraid what people will think if she speaks up about her opinions, the silent person who maybe has been through some stuff in the past of people taking advantage of you, the silent person who's maybe finally going through relationship changes because you've had too much, and you're looking for a pod of women to lift you up and guide you through your next stage of your business, to finally make that revenue and that income that you'd love to have while you feel confident, amazing. You are showing the fuck up and people are loving it and saying that you're inspiring them, and they're sending you messages saying, thank you for sharing your story with us. You lift us up. Please share more of yourself. Then you should join the Confident Woman Collective, especially if you've been joining me for a while, following me for a while, and maybe you've even reached out, and the investment levels that I have typically in my programs are higher than you are able to invest. This is a much lower investment level, much lower investment level that we're only offering if you reach out by the end of the year and join the Confident Woman Collective. And in addition to that, if you're not quite sure yet, we are offering a week's free resource, a free week's training, through which every guide is going to show up and going to train you and going to guide you through exercises that are going to be internally shifting you from feeling like there's constant thoughts ruminating through your head and spinning cycles that never end, keeping you up at night, making you wake up early in the morning, unable to truly focus in the conversation in front of you because you're thinking about the other thing. We're going to guide you through all that for just a week only, and it's completely free. These coaches are like me. We're high ticket coaches. Typically, it's quite the investment to work with us, and we're gifting you a free week of being guided through us. And we're going to teach you how to go from surviving, sleep deprived, anxious, perhaps eating whatever's in front of you because you don't even have time to cook for yourself. You have all these goals, like maybe writing a book or truly launching your business, or even being live on a podcast as a guest, but you're not showing up because there's something keeping you and you're too overwhelmed anyways. You barely have time for what you're doing right now. How could you make all that happen? We're going to teach you how. In our week's free training, we're going to teach you how to go from surviving to thriving, easily making money, having ample time to sleep in, not even having to set your alarm clock. You're spending hours reading, cooking your favorite food, showing up as an expert in all of these TV shows and podcasts. We're going to show you how to do that. And we're going to give you all the information within 1 week in this complimentary training week, starting January 3rd. In the group from surviving to thriving within 90 days. I'll share the link in the show notes or the descriptions. Please click to join now. There's not much action going on now because we're starting January 3rd, but there's going to be chances to win prizes. Definitely a chance to shift the shit out of yourself and truly make shit happen in 2022. And it's all free with some guided exercises to have incredible moments of clarity so you know exactly what to do next in your life to make the things happen that you'd love to happen. The link will be in the description or it will be in the show notes. And if you want more information about it, you can also PM me too. Have a good day, guys. Bye.